Today's two-minute tutorial will examine the Bibliographic Record workform in the Polaris staff client. To access a Bib Record, open the Bibliographic Record Find tool, found under Cataloging, Bibliographic Records. Enter your search terms and select Search. For this example, we will perform a title, exact match, implicitly truncated search for Horton Hears a Who. Double-click on an entry in the results list to open that Bib Record. At the top of the screen is a toolbar, which includes icons to perform actions such as cutting, pasting, saving the record, checking headings, placing holds, and more. These actions are duplicated in the drop-down menu options as well. Please note the links drop-down menu. This menu includes handy links to related work forms, such as the list of item records under this bib and the holds queue. The header contains information such as a control number, the number of items linked to this bib, and if the bib record displays in the pack. Cooperative Computer Services should be set as the owner for all bib records in the system. You are able to navigate through the different parts of a bib record using the menu on the left-hand side of the workform. Let's look at these views. First is the Mark Editor view. This displays the mark record in an editable format. Clicking on a tag, such as the 008, may open a pop-up screen that provides details of included subfields. The second view in a bib record is the pack view. This displays the record as it would appear in the power pack, including cover art and the type of material, or TOM, format icon. This view is helpful for previewing how any changes will be displayed to patrons. Pack previews are available for all items, including those that are shadowed. The next view is the statistics page. This is where you can find circulation statistics for the bib record. Please note that lifetime circulation is a total of all items associated with this bib record, including deleted items. The resource entity view displays information for integrated e-content, including vendor information and the link to the vendor's repository. Since we are currently looking at a printed book, there will be no information in the resource entity view. Finally, the bound width view is used to display information if this record is part of a bound width group. Bound with groups are items such as pamphlets that are physically bound together but fall under individual item and bib records. This view will likely be very rarely used. Before exiting a bib record, make sure to save any changes. Use the File drop-down menu to exit or select the X for the window. This has been a two-minute tutorial on the Bibliographic workform in the Polaris staff client. If you have any questions, please email help@ccslib.org.